Hey guys, it's Meg. I am back this week with a new tarot reading for you. If you guys are seeing this, I am actually still out of town and I will be back on the 28th. So hopefully things will resume business as per usual. I'm foreseeing being highly, highly jet lagged. So we'll see how true that statement ends up being. For those of you that don't know, I've been in France for the last couple of weeks, which has been so gorgeous. You guys, oh my god, I cannot believe how lucky I am to have experienced this trip. But if you are seeing this video, I'm still in France, so hang in there with me. Business will resume as usual. If you guys like what you see in the video, please go ahead and click the like, subscribe, and the bell buttons, so you can stay in the loop for when I post new work. I also have included links to my website, social media, all of that jazz. So if you're interested in getting in touch with me, or you know, letting me know that you're interested in a commission, I will have all of that in the description below. As for commissions, they have been closed for the time being, but there is a contact form on my website, so please go ahead and use that if you are interested in finding out more about how you can commission me. I keep forgetting to mention it, but please know that they're optional. It's there if you want it. If not, your consideration is so very deeply appreciated. So, let's get into the reading. At this time, we are going to be using several decks. The first one we're going to start with, you've seen me use before, English Meg, you did major in it. This is the Work Your Light Oracle by Rebecca Campbell. We're going to start here. For those of you that are new and have never seen me do a reading like this before, I usually like to pull from the middle, start by pulling middle cards, and then use the bottom and the top card as our hidden and clarifying energies. So, to get started, let's shuffle. Oh, also, just as a mention while I'm shuffling, if this video is resonating with you, you were meant to see this. This is done in gratitude and appreciation for you being here and for your friendship. Thank you so much. And let's see the cards you want to see. Oh, okay. Dance with life. First card straight up. Do something to change your energy. I get the sense from this card coming out that there's some stagnancy and some staleness around you, and it's not that's the word that landed on me. It's not a fun energy, and it's not one that you it isn't one that you have really ever entertained might come up for you. No. let's do something about this, right? Let's change our flow. Let's change, you know, there might be a boulder in our stream. Let's change the stream shape so we can get around this boulder, right? You know, and having said that, maybe there's a sense of persistence. And a sense of urgency to get something out of your way so you can change that energy, right? Okay, let's see how the story can continue. So there's our Dance with Life card. You're gonna shuffle. I'm feeling a three card pull for each section. Let's see what happens though. Might just start pulling random numbers and see how we can continue the story. So, let's do that. Let's start here. In the beginning, You know, in the beginning of the reading, we got the Dance with Life card. Let's see, the hidden energy is the Age of Light. Okay, so the tagline in this is, you've been training for this for lifetimes. So there's a challenge coming up for you. And it's suggesting to me that you might be doubting yourself a little bit. Okay? It's okay. I mean, we all go through that emotion. I've been there lots of times before, as has everybody. I think it's time for you to start trusting yourself, and know that you have all the skills and all of the beautiful resources at your fingertips you could ever need to make something happen for yourself. Okay? Again, experiencing self-doubt is totally normal, and it's not something that it's not something to be denied. It's like, oh, I don't believe in myself. No, I can't feel this way. But no. If you're feeling that way, you're feeling that way for a reason, okay? And you know, I don't know if it's necessarily a bad thing to reflect on why, because maybe there's a root cause, but also believe enough in yourself to know that I've been doing this for a while. I've been training for this thing to come for a long time. I got this. Okay, I got this on lock. Let's see what happens. So there's the Age of Light. That was the hidden energy. Okay, every time I've worked with this deck, the initiation has come out. You are being called to leave behind your darkness. You're being called to go through a door that you might not have entertained before. Right? This is what you've been training for, you guys. You have some things that you need to leave behind in your past, because they are holding you back, okay? And it's stagnating your energy. That's upside down. That's stagnating your energy, okay? You know, okay, I'd ask you what you're waiting for, but you know what? Maybe there's a point in your experience with this that you have to take a step back and reflect, and that is perfectly normal. That is absolutely okay. Please don't rest on your laurels too long, because you're going to miss the opportunities that are coming in for you. Look and get you in close. Look at what's coming. Look at that horizon. Look at that beautiful shoreline. All of this is dark. This is stormy. You're not seeing all of the blessings in front of you, okay? This is what you need to go through. Now let me read the card to you, because I said the initiation. There's a rite of passage and crossing the threshold, okay? This in here, this dark, black, stormy space, that's your comfort zone. Nothing grows here. Nothing is warm here. Nothing is bright and light and happy here. You know, you're comfortable there. That's what you know, okay? But what grows there? What are you learning there? We talked about a stagnant energy coming into you, and leaving the stagnancy, leaving this place behind, crossing that threshold from darkness into light, you are going to have so much happiness and peace and love and light coming to you, but you got to go through the door to find it, okay? You got to go through the door to find it. Okay, we're leaving it there. Because I feel like anything else I could say would kill the point a little bit. Moving on, we are going to go into The Soul's Journey by James Van Praagh. Again, this is a new deck, so I am interested in seeing the message, how we can continue the story of the initiation card. and I'm impressed every time I've worked with the Work Your Light Oracle. There's this card has come out, so clearly there's some things that, you know, especially for me personally, I need to do to cross that threshold. But I think for the collective right now, it's an important message to hear too. So whatever that rite of passage may look like for you, you know, I hope you're okay, but it's time to go through that threshold. So one more shuffle and we'll see the card in the middle and the hidden and hidden clarifying energy. So the card in the middle, ooh, what did I tell you guys? We have abundance coming. I love it. And the card reads, I'm a limitless being and I can manifest whatever I desire in this physical reality. Hell yes, you can. Hell yes, you can. You know why? Look what's coming out. You're being called. You are being called. And you know that beautiful shoreline, it's giving you this. Why wouldn't you want to go for that? Guys, your energy is not where you want it to be, and you need to change your flow. You know why? It's holding you back, and you might be afraid, but guys, you've done it before, you're doing it again, you've had lifetimes of training and a lot of ego death in your past in order to get here, okay? Gotta breathe. I know I'm getting a little animated, but I couldn't have planned any better for this to happen. Yeah, you've been training for this all your life, and you're ready. You were so ready. Oh yeah, you're ready, because look at what's on the other side of that doorway for you. You're stepping into an amazing, fruitful, blessed, incredible time. Okay, and let's face it, we've been through the actual shit in 2020 and for a good portion of this year too, okay? But things are coming, you know, things are changing, and for better or for worse, I really do think if we stay the course all together as a collective, and if you continue learning and growing and changing right along with the times, no matter how difficult that may seem, you are going to have so much in your arsenal that you have to share with others. You can make anything you want happen, okay? Because you've been training. You've been doing this for a while now, and you're going to continue to do it for a while longer. So hold on to that abundance, okay? Okay, all right, cue to breathe. Here we go. It's our card in the middle. Let's see our hidden energy and our clarifying energy. I'm sorry you seem a little flat right now, but after this, I mean, a lot of energy just came out right at you guys. Thank you for being patient with me. Let's do another shuffle and see our hidden energy. We have self-esteem, okay? And this reads, I possess gifts of the soul that benefit me and others. Yeah, you do. Yeah, you fucking do. I'm sorry for the swearing, but guess what? What did I say just not a minute before? You've been doing this for a while. You've been manifesting for a while. You've created. Yeah, you've created the abundance because you've done the work to get here first, okay? And look at how confident and gorgeous and amazing and beautiful you are. You know, believe me or not, you've done the work. Maybe you've done the work. Again, here's all that emotional energy coming right out at you. You know, maybe you never thought you could do the thing you've always dreamed of doing. I didn't think I was ever going to get to France. especially last year when everything was looking really dark. But you know, I had to just trust that things were going to work the way they were going to work, for better, for worse. Okay, and why do I bring that up? Because my dad recently showed me the seating, the receipt for the tickets, for plane tickets. And I think he was more excited about it than I was, I think. The point of that is that I manifested the best possible outcome no matter whether we went to France or not. You know, it works. Back to the original point, you have done so much work and you should feel so hecking proud of yourself. Look at how you've grown. Your gifts and your spiritual energy is beautiful, and it's going to help so many people realize their spiritual and physical gifts as well. Yeah, and so here's your self-esteem, here's our hidden energy, let's see our clarifying energy. Doubt, yeah, okay, you gotta release this. But this is the thing. You've come through so much. You've come through so much, and maybe you don't feel like you have everything in check up here. You doubt whether your abilities are actually going to benefit others, even though you've manifested this beautiful thing, this abundance here, and you've been doing it for a long time, right? There's still this little chipping away of your, you know, this little voice in the back of your head that says, well, really, can you? Are you sure? Are you sure? Pokey, pokey, jab, jab. Let me just get a raw nerve there. No. Hush. You know, from Luca, I've seen the ad, Silenzio Bruno. Silenzio Bruno. Right? Just turn it off. Turn it off. You turned it off before, you can turn it off again. Because guess what? Guess what? Okay. Again, moving on. Yeah. You've got a lot of good things coming to you. Especially because you've done the work. This little Bruno ain't shit in this. Okay? Doubt, what is this? What is this? You've done the work. Look at what you've got on your plate right now. You're doing this, Bruno. Shut up. Shut up. Get out of my head. You're not paying bills. So, doubt has no place in your space, sweetie. Let's leave it there. So, we're gonna move into the Daily Crystal by Heather Askenozzi. Let's see what other motivational content we can come to by reading these cards. Ooh, okay. One more shuffle. Let's see the card in the middle, please. Okay, we have Black Kyanite. So first things first, we gotta set some strong boundaries, okay? Because we've done all of this work to boost our self-esteem, raise our abundance. We've gone past that threshold of staying hidden, staying quiet about who we are. Yeah, it's time to bring ourselves to a place where we can share and we can give, but we can't, you know, we can't give so much that the phrase use it or lose it came to mind, and I don't understand why that phrase is coming out, only because my point is that you don't want to diminish your tank, okay? Although I do see now how it applies, because we have all of these things that we've worked so hard to gain, We've gained self-esteem, we've gained abundance, we've gone through the door, we've been training all of this time to be able to share that abundance. But, you know, the Four of Pentacles out of the tarot energy came to mind, because can't be stingy. There's a lot of lessons that we have to share that people could learn from, okay? But we can't drain ourselves so much that we lose the feeling and the power and the passion of doing the work we want to do, right? So yeah, set some strong boundaries, know your limits and know other people's limits so that you don't necessarily clash over that. Yeah, so you don't necessarily clash. So there's the Black Kyanite. Let me shuffle and see what our hidden energy is and our clarifying energy. So for our hidden energy, we have Labradorite. Yes, one of my favorites. I'm actually tuning. Let me get it out right now. I'm actually tuning a new piece right now. It's hard to see, but there is the little sparkly bits in here. So yeah, here's my note. Ooh, there she goes. Thank you. Actually, that's probably the glare from the computer screen, but whatever. She's there. But I am tuning new piece. Here, we're being asked to see our own magic. See the magic. It's around you. Okay? It is a really beautiful energy. And you've done the work. You have done so much good and beautiful, amazing work on yourself and for others. And the magic is around you. So, you know, open your eyeballs and you will see it. Okay? So there's our hidden energy. Our clarifying energy is aquamarine. Baby! What did we talk about? The very first card. The very first card, dance with life, do something to change your energy. Again, we talked about stagnancy and, you know, changing that flow, okay? And we've worked so hard to get ourselves around that boulder. Now it's time to go with the flow. Share what you can without diminishing your energy, and know that you are loved and supported by everybody around you that's meant to be around you, okay? Just go with the flow. Life will give you what it gives you. But there's so many opportunities to learn and grow and change. Yep, yeah. Go with the flow. There's our aquamarine. Okay, alrighty. So, that was out of the Daily Crystal. We're gonna move into the tarot, and I have two decks for you guys. We're gonna start by using the Rider-Waite tarot. And I think what I'm gonna do is take a minute to arrange my cards a little bit, and I don't mean pull cards that I think are resonant out and randomly shuffle, but we're going to use the Rider-Waite Tarot in combination with the Harmonious Tarot by Walter Crane and Ernest Fitzpatrick. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to alternate cards coming out of either deck, and you'll see what I mean by that. So going to shuffle, I think in total of 6 cards for the tarot. So hang in there with me. Give me a minute and we'll see what happens. So we have middle, bottom, top. Okay. Alrighty. Thank you. these mini decks. And also the Harmonious Tarot is a new deck for me as well. I've been working a little bit with that, but it's done me good so far. So let's see what we can do with this. See the middle, bottom, and top. Okay. So our first card is going to come from the Rider-Waite. We have the King of Pentacles. You'll hold that in there for you. Yeah, you've done some work, my friend, because look at the abundance you are in now. Okay? You are in charge of your resources. You are in charge of your materials. You've grown a lot, you've changed a lot, and you are in it now, and you deserve to be there because you have done so much to get yourself where you are now. So there is the King of Pentacles. Next card, we have the Six of Cups. So you've done some reconnecting. Okay, here we go. Let me get that in frame for you. You've reconnected with your inner child. You've recalled wild, amazing dreams you used to have. Maybe there was something that you really wanted to pursue that you never got the chance to, simply because you might have been trained to think that your dreams were impossible. Let me give you a real world example here. I used to really, really want to be an actress, to the point that I would get, we would get mailers for like kids theater agencies and things like that. I was like, Mom, please, please, please. And my mom's like, no. I think she knew something about me then that I didn't know, because I think one thing I have is stage fright, just from performing and being in public speaking and things like that. And I think I liked the thought of being an actress more than I liked the work. So, the point of me mentioning that is that you've reconnected with yourself. There's a sense of nostalgia, a sense of coming home, particularly to yourself. And you have worked, again, you've worked really hard. You've worked really hard to get yourself here. You've worked hard for this King of Pentacles energy too, sweetie. So don't even worry about it. Don't even worry about it. Here you are. Let's do this. Okay. Next card. Got the Page of Cups. So you have a lot to offer at this time. And people are seeing that, which is why you want to set those boundaries. Okay, I'm going back to the Black Kyanite. That's why you want to set those boundaries, because while you are giving, you're very generous. Look at the cup. You're extraordinarily giving, and you have a lot of emotion and things to help. You're a helper, you're in service to people. Maybe your job is a public servant of some kind. You have a lot of good and beautiful qualities about you. Because I feel safe in saying that, because I don't think the job you have would allow you to really do it well if you were being kind of stingy. I think that's how I want to say that. So, there's a lot of lessons that you've learned along the way, and now you're figuring out how to apply them in your space. Because again, you've got a lot to offer, but you got to set those boundaries too. Because remember, again, with the Black Kyanite. So, here's the Page of Cups. Next card, we have the Hierophant. Again, you're not alone. I remember, I think it was a past reading that I gave, that I kept getting that message. And, you know, that's a message for me, especially because I've had experiences and traumatic experiences where I've come out of them feeling monolithic, even though that's not like it's just I'm alone. I have nobody. I have to travel this alone, no matter how hard and difficult this becomes, right? No, you're never alone. Call it what you want, spirit, universe, God, angels, whatever you want to put in there, okay? You're not alone. You have never been alone. You never will be alone. You might be alone in physical form. And that's where I think, you know, people get tripped up. It's where people get tripped up, especially in this case, because the Hierophant to me represents a confidant, an authority, maybe in spiritual or religious matters. Again, you have support. You have support. And equally as fun is that I like this card is coming up in this reading because my star sign is attached to the Hierophant as the major arcana. To think about that for a minute here. It's okay. You're not alone. You are never alone. You never will be alone. Okay. So there's the Hierophant. Okay. You have the sun. Oh my God, you have the sun. Yes. This is light and growth and warmth and abundance, and you are in so much good right now. Things are growing. Things are growing, and yes, I'm leaving it there, son. No, I'm not going to leave it here, actually, because you have a lot of clarity in your situation. You have a lot of happy, warm, bright energy that is going to radiate out in the world. You're radiating. Yes, you are. Of course you are. You have done so much work. And you deserve accolades for that work, okay? Here's the sun. Okay. Next card, we have the Knight of Wands. So you are taking action on your passions and what's getting you out of bed. You are driven by your intellect and the way that you problem solve, okay? Again, you are passionate, you are bright, you are beautiful, okay? Be careful, you know, you don't let this get out of hand, because the Knight of Wands might denote a character that is very much about going after them things that they want, and they want it right away, right? Might not care who they burn in the process of getting there. Be careful, especially if that last sentence describes you. No shade. I'm just saying, please be careful, right? And on the flip side, because you got the sun as well, there's a lot of energy here, and you know how to harness it. You know how to harness it, and you know how to take action in growing your passions. So stick with it, my love. You are doing great. I love you. I love you, and I always wish the best for you, but this reading confirmed that the best will come for you. So there is the Knight of Wands. And I think what all of that is saying is that you're going to do some amazing things with your energy. So just stay the course. stay the course, do the work, hang in there, and my God, are you ever going to be in a great place. So that is it for this reading, guys. Thank you for tuning in. If you like what you see, please go ahead and do all of the things, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Love you lots, everybody.